One of the most common questions I got on my last video was, how do you make the grass tiles look like this? Specifically, the stripy grass texture is larger than the bounds of a single tile, yet everything still tiles seamlessly. Normally, when creating tiles for 2D games, there's a one-to-one mapping between each tile's texture and its in-game representation. But the tile size really limits what you are able to draw, and it can often turn out looking very repetitive. So for my game, I wanted a different approach. I wanted to be able to spread a large texture across multiple tiles while still keeping the original tile edges. This allows for textures of any size, offering much more creative freedom. So, how does it work? The short answer is, I used a shader. But before you start expecting something super complicated, don't worry. This time, it's only a few lines of code. So let's go through how it works, starting with a blank shader and blank tiles. If you try to sample the texture using the default tile UVs, you'll end up with something like this. Not exactly what we're after. Instead, let's use the world position of our tiles. In Godot, this means calculating the world position in the vertex shader like so, and then accessing it from the fragment shader. Initially, it looks even worse than before. But to fix this, we just have to set the texture mode to repeat enable and make our texture larger using a scale parameter. You can tweak the scale manually to see what looks best, or if you want it to look pixel perfect, you can use this formula. So now we have a large repeating texture applied to the tile map. But unfortunately, the original tile edges are now gone. To preserve the tile edges, I decided to use the color red as a mask. The idea is, areas that are fully red will have the new texture applied, and areas that aren't will just keep the original tile design. In the code, we can achieve this by flooring the red channel, and then using that value to blend between the original tile map and the overlay texture. And that's it! That's the entire shader! I've been using this shader for lots of other tile maps in my game too, not just the grass. It's also on the roads, soil, creeks, and even these bushes. There are some limitations with the shader though. In its current state, it can only handle one type of tile. I generally keep different types of tiles on separate layers, and so I can apply the shader to each tile map individually. But that might not always be the case, and sometimes you might have all your tile types on the one layer. We can extend the shader to handle this though. Here, we pass in two overlay textures, and we'll use red as a mask for the first one and blue as a mask for the second. Then instead of applying the shader to the whole tile map at once, we can actually just apply it individually to each tile. The end result should look exactly the same as before, but now all your tiles can be on the same layer. Alright, that's all I have for today. I hope you found this video helpful. As usual, there will be links to the code in the description, including a version for Unity. Thanks for watching.